Thermography versus mammogram. What do you do to decide? Is thermography as good as mammography? What's an alternative to a mammogram? Are mammograms bad for you? What do you do to get the facts? What do you do to get the facts about breast thermography? Thermography is also called digital infrared thermal imaging, or DITI, infrared thermography, or IRT, thermal imaging and thermograms. But they all mean the same thing. Thermography is used everywhere by governments to protect their citizens' health. If you caught a plane at a sizeable airport in the last 10 years, you'll have had a thermograph, even though it's cursory compared with what we're looking at here. Pauline Rose is probably Australia's leading therapist in this field, and her rooms are on Sydney's North Shore. I met her when conducting research for a group of clinics decades ago, and I've picked her brains ever since when needing advanced medical knowledge. Those of you asking questions online want answers, so I gave Pauline a call. Pauline, is thermography as good as mammography?
Well, you really can't compare them because they measured quite different things. Thermography measures the function that's going on in the body or in the breast, and mammography measures the anatomy. So you can't compare them from that way.
So the goal of thermography is to measure the temperature variations that a biological process might cause using light, whereas the goal of mammography is to measure what is physically apparent using X-rays. What is the most accurate test for breast cancer?
Well, the most accurate test for breast cancer is pathology, following a biopsy. But you don't rush into that. There is a lead up to that. And usually the first part of that story is having a thermogram done. If we find something that's suspicious at that stage, and often well in advance of the anatomical screenings, we will refer someone on for either an ultrasound, a mammogram, or an MRI. Now, if that is then positive, a patient will be invited to have a biopsy.
Women especially ask, what is an alternative to a mammogram? Why? Should you not get a mammogram?
Well, there's a lot of women we found who simply don't have mammograms for the reasons that they don't like them. And therefore, you need something in that gap. Now, that's where thermography comes in. It's very safe. It's comfortable. It will encourage women to be screened. I'm then very good at encouraging women to have anatomical screening if needed. And the early detection is a good reason to have it. And we can also screen younger women. A mammography is more suitable for the women over 50. But unfortunately, nowadays, there's a lot of younger women getting breast cancer.
You refer women for anatomical screening, meaning mammograms, when that is needed. However, as mammography is better suited for women over 50, shouldn't thermography be top priority for younger women, especially when they now appear to be suffering from breast cancer? As it measures a finely tuned biological function and records it over time, wouldn't it register any anomalies quite early?
Yeah, that's right. We've got lots of cases that we might be monitoring over a period of time at regular intervals once we've ruled out that it can't be seen anatomically at that point, but it will eventually show down the track. But in the meantime, you can manage the hormones, you can manage the inflammation, and you may keep that woman safe, almost forever, really, with good intervention.
Do breast implants affect mammograms?
Well, thermography is a very good solution for these women as well. And if I had a woman with a breast implant and I was suspicious that there was something else there, I would actually refer her for an ultrasound.
And why an ultrasound, not mammogram?
Because they don't have to have compression of the implants. And we do have problems with implants leaking as well, so we have to be very cautious about that.
Are there any exceptions to a normal breast thermography session?
Oh, yes. Look, women with extremely large breasts, we may have to take some extra photographs. We often take shots from underneath as well. But that's the only issue.
Just more photos?
Just more photos.
Pauline, does thermography help with fibrocystic breast tissue?
Fibrocystic breast tissue is very common, and it usually involves an estrogen dominance as well. Now, this is a manageable, benign condition. If you leave it unattended, it may turn nasty over a long period of time, but this is a condition we monitor. We see it, we treat it, we monitor it, usually with very good results.
Do you ever advise against thermography screening?
Now the time that we don't screen women is when they're pregnant or breastfeeding. We like to wait at least 3 months after they've stopped breastfeeding. And this is because the hormones put extra inflammation into the breast. It's a normal thing, but we're best to screen outside that period of time.
Would you recommend thermography for women who are in menopause?
Oh, menopause is a very good time to have a screening done because it's when our hormones play up across the board, usually, and that can invite a lot of adverse changes in the body. People talk about the breast, but you'll be surprised how often we pick up thyroid problems in women in this age group. Well worth looking at.
What about postmenopausal women?
Just the same, except I will say that if you get to being 70, 75 years on, the type of breast cancer that you're going to get is probably a DCIS. Some countries even consider that's not a real cancer, and it's very slow growing. So it doesn't show up. This is where it doesn't show as well as the other types of tumours that we might see. And it's often better for a woman in that age group, if she's concerned about something, perhaps to have a mammogram.
How long can you have breast cancer without knowing?
Oh, quite some time. The majority of breast cancers are still diagnosed by the woman finding the lump. And she's been growing that for quite some time. So she finds a lump, she goes to a doctor, and then she gets a diagnostic screen and a biopsy.
And I imagine you discover lumps that people have been unaware they had.
Oh yes, quite often. Yes.
Ouch. Pauline, you said you refer patients for mammograms when necessary, yet I've read numerous studies, including one conducted by researchers from the Netherlands Cancer Institute and other institutions in Europe and the US, urging caution. And the study suggests that there's an increased risk of breast cancer if, before the age of 30, certain women are exposed to even low doses of radiation used in diagnosis. And the researchers called for diagnostic imaging techniques that do not involve radiation to be considered in high-risk women. What's your view on this?
That research study would be referring to what we call the BRCA genes. And this is the small group of women who have a familial type of cancer. It's only about 10% of breast cancers. But they've now discovered that exposure to radiation for these women can accelerate the growth of the tumour. So the old-fashioned idea of frequently screening these women from a young age is now losing favour.
So I guess they've got an option.
Yeah, so, you know, thermography is a good outcome for those people.
Well, mammography was thoroughly investigated with results published in the Cochrane report, and that's readily available and, I would hope, read by any patient or practitioner. Has that information affected how we use mammograms?
Yeah, that's probably the best known of the breast cancer studies. And it was released almost at the same time as the Canadian study. And as a result, that has changed people's views around doing mammograms as often as they did. And Switzerland has already decided not to do screening mammograms. They only do them for diagnostic purposes now. And I understand Denmark and Sweden, last I saw, were looking at changing their rules about that too. Another outcome at that time was the introduction of breast density laws that came in throughout a lot of Europe and almost every state in America. Women with very dense breasts find it very hard to have mammograms and get any justifiable result because the radiologist can't see very well. on those types of women. So they now have to be informed that they've got dense breasts and invited to have another form of screening.
And finally, Pauline, what do the colours mean in thermography?
Well, the colours in thermography, the normal colours are yellow and green. And the abnormal colours at times are red and blue. Of course, nothing's quite as simple as that, but a cluster of red in one particular area may indicate that we need to do a scan for a tumour. A lot of blue could mean there's poor circulation, maybe through a heart or through limbs, and then we might investigate that further as well.
And what's that picture on your screen at the moment?
This image that I've got up on the screen at the moment is a young woman with breast cancer that we found. And you can see there's a really marked red pattern across one breast and in the lymph nodes under one arm. So we immediately refer her for a full clinical workup, which includes a mammogram and an ultrasound, which, you know, led to her having a biopsy and then full treatment for her breast cancer.
That's very sad, but thankfully she got treatment because she had thermography. I guess it's simple, safe and swift, and that 10 minutes might have saved a life. As Pauline says, thermography and mammography are quite different from one another as to how and what they measure. Thermography plays an important role in overall monitoring of both human and animal health. In relation to human breast screening, Pauline uses thermography and also recommends mammograms, ultrasound and magnetic resonance imaging, or MRI, as you heard her state. But technology develops, information increases. And since speaking with Pauline, Lancet published findings from a 23-year follow-up of the UK AGE trial on breast screening. Especially when our health's involved, we're admonished to check every procedure proposed and the bona fides of every health professional we employ. There are more videos answering online questions in this series on thermography. So I hope that when you ask, what do you do to know about thermography, they help give you greater understanding of the topic.